Dart is a programming language designed for client development. It is developed by Google. It is an object-oriented, class-based, garbage-collected language with C-style syntax. It can compile to either native code or JavaScript and supports interfaces, mixins, abstract classes, generics, and type inference. Flutter allows you to build apps for mobile, web, desktop, and embedded devices. As Flutter framework is on the rise, everyone is creating apps in Flutter. The purpose of this unique video is to teach you better ways to write Dart code and avoid bad Dart code. Watch until the end and take notes as you go. It can be used in a job, technical interview, or simply to show off your smart coding skills to your friends. We have a list of numbers from 1 to 5 and we want to reverse the list. On the reverse method, we create a variable result with initial value as an empty list of numbers. We use the standard for loop I starts at list size minus 1 until I is greater than 0, and at each iteration we decrement I. In this way, we are looping on the array from the last element to initial element. On the result variable, we add each element of the array. We return the result variable. On the debug console, we see the initial array in reverse order. Another approach is, on the reverse Dart method, we return the list.from. This will convert the collection into a list. We pass the initial list call in the reverse method. This will generate a new collection with reverse numbers. On the debug console, we see the initial array in reverse order. A similar approach is to use an arrow function. On the reverse method declaration, we use the arrow symbol and invoke the initial array. Call it the standard reverse method and convert into a list. Another approach to this one is using the same arrow function and use the spread operator inside the list, represented by square brackets, to transform a list reverse collection into a list. On the debug console, we see the initial array in reverse order. We have a list of numbers. We want to return the sum of all numbers in the list. On the sum method, we use an if to check if the input array is empty to return 0. We create a num variable initializing at 0. Use the standard for loop on the array, assign the sum variable to sum itself with every element of the array. At the end, we return the sum variable. On the debug console, we see the sum of all elements of the array. Another approach is, instead of using the standard for loop, we use the for in loop. The sum will be assigned by summing itself with the number variable that represents each element of the array. At the end of the method, we return the sum variable. Another short approach is to use the for each loop as a callback, each element of the array represented by number, and assign the sum by summing itself with number. Return the sum variable at the end of the method. A smarter approach is, on the sum method, return by checking if array is not empty, invoke array.reduce method, in which the callback has two params, the current value and the next value. On the array, in the method body of the callback, we return the current value sum with the next value. If the array is empty, we return the zero value. Another shorter and smarter approach is, on the sum method, we return the array by calling the fold method that expects the initial value and the callback, as we saw on the reduce method. The initial value will be assigned to the current value, and if the array is empty, it will return zero. If you want to learn Flutter, master the Dart language. No question asked. We have a list of numbers and we want to return the sum of all square numbers in the list. If the array is empty, we return 0 without further logic. We create a variable sum and initialize as 0. We use a standard for loop and assign the variable sum as the summation of each element of the array multiplied by itself. We return the sum variable and on the console log, we see the result. A better approach is, if the array is empty, we return 0 without further logic. We create a variable sum and initialize as 0. We use a for in loop and assign the variable sum as the summation of each element represented by number variable multiplied by itself. We return the sum variable. A smarter approach is, we use a for each loop and pass the callback that receives element of the array as e variable. We assign sum as the summation of each element represented by variable e. We return the sum variable and on the console log we see the result. A shorter approach is, we invoke the reduce method on the array. The callback receives the params current and next variables. On the callback body, we return current value plus next time next. If the array is empty, it returns 0. A smarter approach is, we invoke the fold method on the array with initial value as 0. And the body of the callback the same, current plus next times next variable. We have a list of numbers and we want to return the multiplication of all numbers in the array. We create a variable mult and initialize at 1. We use the for each loop on the array and multiply the mult variable with each element of the array. We return the mult variable. A shorter approach is we use the fold method on the array and initialize with 1. On the callback method, we return p variable times e variable. Another approach is we use the reduce method on the array. On the callback method, we return a variable times v variable. Developers consider Dart to be the fastest and most expressive way to build native apps. We have two numbers and we want to see the numbers can multiply together to get another number. On the isFactor.Dart method, we return base divided by factor. If the remainder is 0, return true, otherwise false. A simpler approach is to return the division of base with factor comparing with 0. An alternative approach is to use the remainder Dart method available in Dart language on the integer and passing the factor as argument, the return compares it to 0. We have a number, we want to return even or odd strings to the console. On the even or odd method, we return the number divided by 2. If the remainder is 0, it is even, otherwise odd. Alternatively, you can invoke the Dart reminder method on the provided number and pass the number 2 as argument. If the result is 0, return even, otherwise odd. A smarter approach is check by invoking the isEvenDart method on the integer, and if that is true, return even. And do the same check with isOddDart method on the integer, and if that is true, return odd. Or simply, you can use the isEven method on the number, and if that is true, return even, otherwise return odd. A quicker approach is return an array of even and odd strings and passing as index the result of number divided by 2. If the result is 0, means it is even and 1 is odd, and with this we'll pick up the right position on the array. And a similar approach but with less code is returning the same array of even and odd strings and passing as index the number with and symbol and 1. Despite being similar to JavaScript, Dart runs code several times faster. We want to check if the string has at least one uppercase letter. We create the isAllCaps method to implement the logic. On the isAllCaps.Dart method, we create a variable count and initialize as 0. We use a standard for loop to iterate over the string. On the for loop body, we check each position of the string that is a letter and compare to its uppercase version using the uppercase method on the string letter. If that is true, we increment the count variable. At the end, we return the if the count has the same size as the string. Another approach is you use a for loop to iterate over the string. If there is at least one character that is lowercase, return false. At the end of the method, return true. A shorter approach is on the isAllCaps method, return by calling the to uppercase method on the string and compare with original string. Main. This function starts the program. Flutter does not allow us to write any program without the main function.